One of the most difficult things we have to ask ourselves as business owners is, when do we stop? When do we give up? When do we say enough is enough? We've had enough. Notice behind me is normally chock full of materials, gotten rid of all that stuff, and it's gone. And now's the next chapter of our lives. We've got to move on. Hopefully you don't have to move on. Or maybe hopefully you do have to move on. I don't know. But that's what we're going to talk about today on Successful Contractor. Da, da, da. Hey, so we're not like totally done. That was for the people that don't always follow along and know that we're getting a new place. This is the new place. I know, it doesn't look like much. It doesn't look like much. And it's kind of noisy because I don't know if you can hear this, but there's a lot of noise right back here. But that's a good thing because I don't plan on sleeping here. For a business, all that noise, that is music to my ears. That should equate to dollars. That's dollar bills I hear. Come on in, let me show you around. Yesterday, there was nothing in here. Today, desks, people work here. There's a phone. There's literally a phone on that desk. It's amazing. It's not a lot. Like yesterday, we were missing things like doorknobs. Like we had to get a doorknob because that wasn't there. And you're probably thinking that's not a big deal, but the bathroom was also missing a doorknob. So it's like a little people. No one needs to see what goes on there. No paint on this wall, but it's okay. We can make this work. This will work for us. Compared to the office that we had before this, this is a lot better. Like we actually have desks and chairs. This is much better. Look at this guy. This is Micah. For those of you that don't know Micah, say hi, Micah.
How's it going?
Micah came to us from another fence company. This is Jeremy. Hello. You guys all know Jeremy, and they're hard at work. They're selling stuff. They're killing it. Killing stuff and dragging it home. That's what these guys do. Then we have this nice little kitchen. It's a little rough around the edges. You can see some exposed insulation and stuff, but it's all good. This is where you start things. You don't start with the great big fancy building and all the nice stuff. You just start wherever you are. You haven't even seen the outside yet. The old trusty ice maker is here. It's hooked up to the washer dryer hookup, which is very convenient that was right out here for us. I mean, I couldn't ask for a better setup ever. Like, it's perfect. I could see all this in my head when I was looking at this. I'm like, this is gonna be great. It's gonna be great. The office is a little bit rough. And right next door to the office, we had office number two, also known as not an office because, well, it's pretty bad. I'll show you inside. It's pretty bad. Anybody else would have looked at this maybe and said, ew. And the owner was even like, it's a tear down. It just needs to go away and we'll tear it down if you want. And we're like, no, no, no. Please don't tear it down because you know what this is good for? It's good for dry storage. Yesterday was our first day in this space. So we basically have thrown stuff away, thrown stuff in here, and we've got it kind of organized. We've got stuff we've still got to put away. It's definitely a work in progress, especially as far as the outside. Remember how I said this isn't really a house? Well, it's because there's no plumbing, there's no power, there's nothing. It's just the shell. But I don't see any leaks in the ceiling, so it's gonna keep our stuff dry. We're gonna run some ghetto power from the other house over to here, and we're gonna put some lights up in here that are LED, and we'll actually be able to see. Won't be quite as dingy as this, but it allows us to store all of our fittings and stuff like that in here for free. I don't have to pay for anything. I don't have to order a Connex and bring a Connex over here. We haven't even decided what to call it yet. We just call it, I don't know. What do we call it, Jason?
Definitely dark and dingy. And it's a warehouse for now.
Hey, but it's working. It's working. It's organized. We can find stuff. It keeps it dry. Boom. Done. That's a win. So a lot of people, my wife included, were like, I don't know about this. And I was like, no, this is going to be great because we have all this traffic. We've got a nice piece of frontage right there along the traffic that where you can see where we've got our post drove. We drove those posts yesterday and we're going to put up some fence in the next couple days. Put a slide gate right over here on an operator just to kind of showcase what we do and then tie that in just to give us a little bit of security. When we put the fence up there, that'll give us a great place for some advertising for our business. What we like to do and what we've done in all of our other businesses is put windscreen on, and so we'll do that here where we let people know that we're a fence company and what we do and that they can buy materials here and hopefully increase our retail sales. Just basically in general, let the public know what it is that we do here, because right now there's not a lot of signage. People might have noticed that there's more cars here than usual, but we want them to not have any guesses about what is here, and it's a fence company. That'll be going up in the next couple weeks. We'll get all that done. But then the thing I really liked is I like that we have all this space. We have all this space. We have a total of just under 3 acres here. So we've got the office, we've got the dry storage warehouse, the dark and dingy warehouse, we've got all the traffic, and then we have space. In my mind, what I picture is I picture two Connexes and then one of those tarped buildings on the truss and tarp building. If I go 40 by 60, give us about 2,400 square feet under roof, and then we'll have the two Connexes we can store stuff in and keep even more stuff dry, like welders and things like that, and we'll just pull them out. We'll pour concrete in there and we'll have a place to weld and route vinyl. And if we need more space than that for dry, we'll probably just order a couple more shipping containers. We'll probably be $45,000 to $50,000 all in, all done for something that if we ever decide we want to leave, we can pull it all out except for the concrete work and take it with us to the next location or sell it or whatever we need to do. So that's kind of my thought process and all this. And I think it's all gonna work. I think it's gonna work great. The big thing I liked is we needed more room. We have plenty of room. We're not stepping on anybody's toes here. Nobody cares that we're here. We'll get this all cleaned up, maybe put some asphalt millings down here so we don't get stuck in the sand. And it'll be a really great location. So sometimes you have to think outside the box and envision what it can be, not what it is today. We'll see what this thing looks like next year this time. It'll be a whole different place, I bet. I personally have only been stuck out here once so far, once. So yeah, we're definitely gonna need some asphalt millings or something, but I see this great big huge open space right here and I'm thinking this is perfect. It's almost 5,000 square feet of warehouse, covered warehouse right here. That'd be really nice. See right over here? It even came with a pre-made bonfire. Can you say fun? So as you can see, we're just about done cleaning this up. We're gonna keep this particular unit for hopefully just about another month, and then we'll move everything over to the new location. That's gonna be challenging in and of itself, but we'll figure it out because that's always my plan. I don't really have a full plan, like a whole fully developed plan. I operate on a lot of, we're just gonna figure this out as we go along. So if you're thinking I'm a genius, no, I'm just a real risk taker. That's what I do, I take risks. And sometimes we have the highest of highs and sometimes we have the lowest of lows. Yesterday felt like day one almost all over again. It just was nothing went as planned. I want to have a good attitude because it's Monday and I don't think that's necessarily a Monday thing. I think it can happen on Fridays just as much as Monday, but it was very much a you're the bug, not the windshield kind of day. But today it's a little bit better. Maybe we're winning. That coupled with all the stress of moving, it's not been one of my favorite weeks. Probably my favorite 2 weeks. It's just a lot of stress and I'm trying to get to where I can go back to Wyoming and do some stuff that I need to do there and visit family and have birthdays and do the whole nine yards. So goose for ba. We'll be good. It'll be fine. We're not really closing down, so it's all good. Is failure an option? Failure is always an option with me. I learned that from Mythbusters. It is always an option. We could still fail at all this. I've taken a lot of really big risks. I'm a gambler, so that's just what I do. Some people would play it a lot more conservatively than me, but it's just not my style. Bet big, win big. As you can see behind us, we are just about cleared out of here. Hopefully be out of here in a month. One thing I do know from past experiences, I don't want to be in two different locations. They're 20 minutes apart and you will lose so much time and efficiency trying to get things back and forth. And we're already seeing that because we got to come here to route post. And oh, did anybody route post? No. So we got to drive across town, come here, route post, then go back. It's even worse now than it probably would be just because we're still moving. And yesterday was the first day at our new place. We don't even have jobs pulled because we were too busy moving. And so we're trying to catch up so that we're back to our organized fashion and really working at peak efficiency again. So that's just kind of some of the mess that goes along with moving. Moving's never fun. It's never fun, but hopefully the end result will be good and it will bring a huge increase to our business. That's the update for this week. That's what we've been up to. That's what's been causing me my latest bout of stress, and hopefully it will get even better from here. So stay tuned. Glad to have you along on the Successful Contractor channel. I'm Mark with SWI Fence Florida and the Successful Contractor, and I hope you have a good dang day.